Now the topic is field status variant. Field status variant. Very, 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 very important. Field status variant. Basically, what is the objective of field status variant? Everyone, are you able to hear my voice? Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes. What is meant by field status variant? Means concentrate here. At the time of let's imagine Rajkumar is the end user. Just imagine. Okay. He is posting accounting entries and he is generate the reports. Okay. At the time of accounting entry postings, example, he want to post debit and credit, means any accounting entry like rent account data to cash or commission, cash account data to commission received, any accounting entry. One second. Any accounting entry he want to post. But what happened in the SAP, at the time of accounting entry posting, debit side 75 fields and credit side 75 fields is available. Okay, debit side how many fields available? 75 fields is available. And credit side how many fields is available? 75 fields is available. So when he fill all the 75 fields, it will take lot of time. Okay, even this 75 fields is not required to fill all the times. Okay, so what is meant by this field status variant? Field status variant is to control accounting entry fields. It is control the fields at the time of accounting entry posting. For example, every field we have four options. One is like optional and otherwise note it down better. Optional heading is field status variant. Heading is SAP field status variant. SAP field status variant. Field status variant is, note it down. Field status variant is control the fields at the time of accounting entry posting. At the time of accounting entry posting, every field have four options. Every field have four options. Every field have four options. The first one is optional. First one is optional. And required. Next one is required. Required. The third one is display. and fourth one is surplus. Fourth one is surplus. Do one thing. Concentrate here. Example. What is meant by optional? Any field. Example. Do one thing. Let's take business area. Business area. What is meant by business area? Business area nothing but branches. Okay. Business area field available at the time of accounting entry posting. In this business area field, when I make as a optional, at the time of accounting entry posting, you may enter the business area or you may not enter the business area. Okay, that is no problem. System will allow to post accounting entry. And when you make as a required, at the time of accounting entry posting, you must enter business area. Without business area, system can't allow to save the accounting entry. Example, I am taking business area field. Okay. And how many fields is available? Basically 75 fields, debit side 75 fields, credit side. And next one is display. When I make business area is display, at the time of accounting entry posting, it is just displayed. I can't enter any business area into that field. Why? Because it is go to gray mode. I am unable to enter any business area. And what is meant by surplus means when I make as a business area surplus, this business area field not visible at the time of accounting entry posting. Okay, what is meant by field status variant? Field status variant is to control the fields at the time of accounting entry posting. And I will give you one more example. For example, this is the field status variant group. Example G001. This is field status variant group, and here business area optional. Okay, and one more group G002. Just imagine, this is one group and this is one group. What is the group? Field status variant group. And this is also another group. Here, business area. Example I am giving for your understanding purpose. I am giving business area required. Okay, and example, I created rent GL. I created commission paid. This rent GL, I assigned this G001. I assigned in the G001. what happened in the G001 business area is optional. And here the commission paid, I assigned G002. Concentrate here. You just concentrate here. Rent is I assigned G001. Their business area is optional. Commission paid, I assigned G002. Their business area is required. You just understand scenario. Now, at the time of rent accounting entry posting, business area is optional. You may enter the business area, you may not enter business area. There is a business area field, you may enter or you may not enter. And at the time of commission paid accounting entry posting, at the time of commission paid accounting entry posting, business area is required. Why? Because in the G002, I make as a business area required. Okay, so at the time of commission paid accounting entry posting, like commission paid posting, business area is required. So this is the mapping. So based on your mapping to the GL, the accounting entry posting fields will act like that. Okay, anyone, any doubts?
No, sir.
Yeah. Did you got the point?
Yes.
Yeah. And the first one is, what is the first one? Define field status variant. Define field status variant. So what is the field, how to create field status variant? What is the path? Here the path, SPRO, financial accounting new, financial accounting global setting new, ledger and fields, define field status variant. Okay, and what is the T code? OBC4. Yeah, and go to SAP. You need to open SAP. So double click on this. And enter username and password. Everyone, how to create field status variant? Either you can go through path, or either you can go through T code. Whatever process you can use. So this is the path and this is the T code. For your understanding purpose, we make as a like Excel. OBC4 is a T code. This is the path. Example, I am going through path for your understanding purpose. Okay. See this one. Enter your SPRO. Enter SAP reference IMG. And financial accounting new. Then financial accounting global settings. And ledgers, fields, see this one, fields, and this one, define field status variant. So what is the T code on that? If you want to display T code, click on this way, additional IMG activities and keys here. This is the path actually, okay, for display the T code. What is the T code? Last four digit is the T code OBC4. So you just double click, everyone, you just catch the point. You just double click on define field status variant, double click on this. And click on your new entry, or otherwise there is a standard one, 0001 is the standard one. You can use 0001, you can use, why? Because this is the standard one. So based on standard one, you can create your own field status variant, okay, and select here 0001 and click on your copy as. Enter here any four digit, it may be numerical or it may be alphabets. Example GMFV. What is meant by GMFV? GM field status variant. Status variant. Okay, press enter. And copy all means whatever objectives in the 0001, all the objectives copy to GMFV. Click on here all, then click on here all, then select here GMFV, double click on field status groups, double click on this. See this one here, the groups G001, G003, 4, 5, 6, like that. Here I explained right in the Excel. So where is that? See here, G001 and G002 example, and here this, the like this, okay, and go to there. Example, let us take the example, double click on G001, example, double click on G001, and for example, you just double click on additional account assignment. So this is the fields. When this fields is available, at the time of accounting entry posting. Example, plant is available, business area is available, and WBS element is available. So when you click on your example, let's take business area. When you click on your surplus, this field is not visible at the time of accounting entry posting. And when I click on your required, at the time of accounting entry posting, you must enter business area. Required, without entering business area, we can't post accounting entry. And optional, you may enter business area, you may not enter business area. Like this, all the fields, when you click on your page down button in the keyboard, all the fields like this. Example, profit center, I'm click on your optional, example, and click on your page down, and segment, click on your optional. So for the practice, you these three you make as a optional. Business area making as the optional, page down, and profit center making as a optional, and segment making as a optional, all the fields. Then click on your save. Yes, this is the TR, okay. And even for example, you just double click on G001, this is the main fields. Go to general data, all the fields is available at the time of accounting entry posting. Assignment number, text, invoice reference, what is meant by these fields we can understand at the time of accounting entry posting. So what need to understand here, this is the fields available at the time of accounting entry posting. That fields you can control from here, okay, and go back. Like example, additional information, all the fields, and go back. Example, payment transactional, this one, all the fields available at the time of accounting entry posting. Example, payment term, value date, and due date. Yeah, blah blah blah, XYZ. Okay, go back. Click on here, save and back. So any doubts, anyone?
No, Vikram.
Yeah, thank you. Once again, I will have some water, please. Thank you. Yeah. The next one, what is this? Assign company code to field status variant. Assign company code to field status variant. So what is the field status variant? This is the one. Where is that? This is the one. GMFV means GM field status variant. Click on your save. This is the one, right? We created GMFV. And what is our company codes? Our company code is GM20. And what is our field status variant? GMFV. So FV. This GMFV need to assign these two company codes. Mapping. We are mapping to these two company codes. Like this. Okay. What is that? Next option. Assign company code to field status variant. Okay. And go to SAP. Everyone, you just catch the point. What is the path? And this is the path. And this is the T code. What is the T code? OBC5 is the T code. And this is the path. What is the path? SPRO, Financial Accounting New, Financial Accounting Global Settings New, Ledgers, and Fields, Assign Company Code to Field Status Variant. Okay, then go to SAP, then go back, like same path. Financial Accounting New, Financial Accounting Global Settings, Ledger, Fields. This is the Define Field Status Variant. This is Assign Company Code to Field Status Variant. What is the T code? OBC5. And you just double click on here. And click on your position. What is the company code? GM10. Enter. GM10 and GM20. Here you need to assign field status variant. If you remember that 4-digit, you can enter directly. Otherwise, you just click on here this button. And this one, GMFV, GM field status variant. GMFV, click on your save and back. Next one, put the heading tolerance. Yeah, here put the heading tolerance. What is meant by tolerance? Can anyone say what is meant by tolerance?
It is nothing but variance.
This is the variant. My concern is what is meant by tolerance? Meaning, what is the meaning? Why this is the variant? Everyone is variant. Yeah, very good. All the global parameters is the variance. Mr. John, what is meant by tolerance? If you have any idea.
Yeah, just we said that not obligatory.
Okay.
Flexible, we can say. Flexible.
Yes. Yeah, I will tell you one thing. Do one thing. Tolerance means sacrifice. Tolerance means, what is meant by tolerance? To sacrifice. You know, everyone knows sacrifice, right?
Yes.
Yeah, tolerance nothing but sacrifice. Do one thing. I will tell you one thing. And I will give you one best example. And at the time of payment, at the time of payment, you want to pay 100 rupees or 1000 rupees, anyone, 1000 rupees, 0.20 paisa. You know paisas, right? I want to pay 100 rupees, 0.20 paisa. So how much able to pay? Basically, I can pay only 1000 rupees. I am unable to pay this 20 rupee, this 20 paisa, 0.20. So this 20 is sacrificing the value. Got it? Okay. My point. For example, at the time of payment received, I want to receive 1 lakh. 1 lakh point 30 paisa. So how much amount I can receive? Only this 1 lakh rupees. So how much I mean this 30 paisa I am unable to receive. Why? Because this is sacrifice the value. If you want to receive, you can, they will transfer, that is not a matter. Okay, and but we need to sacrifice this 30 paisa. John, are you able to get my point?
Yes, very clear. Yes.
So this is the sacrifice. For example, do one thing. Each transaction, example 30 paisa and 40 paisa, what, how much value for the 10,000 transaction? Each transaction 30 paisa. So what is the value for 10,000 transactions? Or 12,000 transactions, each transaction 30 paisa. It is very big amount actually. Okay. Do one thing. In the tolerance means, we are set one limit. This is disconnected within 1 minute. You please join again. Okay. And I will
start
anyway. I can continue. Tolerance means, I can set one limit. Example, I can set 10 rupees. So at the time of payment and at the time of receipt, you are sacrifice up to this 10 rupees. When you sacrifice more than 10 rupees, system will not allow.
Okay.
Got it, my point? At the time of payment received or vendor payment, customer payment and vendor payment, when you set any limit, example, when I said my limit is 100 rupees, what is meant by 100 rupees? Up. Okay. See, so you can't sacrifice all the value. as per the client requirement, you need to set one limit. Example, when I set 100 rupees is my limit, at the time of payment or at the time of receipt, you need to sacrifice up to 100 rupees. Example, you can sacrifice 50 rupees. Okay, why? Because 100 rupees below is 50, when 50 rupees, 51 rupees, no problem. Like 100 rupees, no problem. Why? Because my limit is 100 rupees. When you sacrifice 101, system will not accept. Why? Because this 101 is exceed of my limit. Okay, so you are setting one limit. So based on that limit, you need to sacrifice the value. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Naveen. Yeah. For example, do one thing. How many types of tolerances in SAP? How many types of tolerances in any SAP? How many types of tolerances? We have 4 types of tolerances available in SAP. Like vendor tolerance means this is used for the vendor payments. Vendor tolerance and customer tolerance and customer tolerance and GL tolerance, general ledger posting time, GL tolerance and employee tolerance.
Okay.
Employee tolerance. So we have 4 types of tolerances is available, like vendor tolerances, customer tolerances, GL, general ledger tolerances and employee tolerances. What is meant by employee tolerance? For example, when you go to any shopping complex, there is any designations like salesman and manager and senior manager and CEO, like that there is some designations. And if your friend is a salesman, he will give some discount. Okay, example, he will give up to 1,000 rupees, he will give some sacrificing. If you have very good relation with the manager, so he gives more than 1,000 rupees. Example, he give 10,000 rupees of sacrifice. So if you very good relation with senior manager, he give like more than very good value. So if you have very good relation with CEO, he give more than sacrifice. Got it my point, everyone? There is some designation. Example,
yes, sir.
Sorry, Andrani? Yeah.
I said just S.
Oh, okay. Very good. For example, once again, for my satisfaction, I will tell you once again. When you go to any sales, sales example, malls, different malls is there, right? Any shopping malls. When you go to any shopping malls, in the shopping malls, there is a designation. What is the designations? Example, salesman and manager and senior manager and CEO, like that. CEO, like any man, any things. So when you have very good relation with the salesman, he give extent of the sacrifice. Example, he give 10 rupees. So when you have very good relation with manager, so he give some more, sacrifice. Example, 100 rupees. Example, I'm telling you. So when you have very good relation with senior manager, so he give one more thing. Example, he give 200 rupees of sacrifice. When you have very good relation with CEO, example, the CEO is your relative. What happened? He give very good sacrifice value. Example, he give 2000 rupees. Like that. This is one scenario for sacrificing the values of employee. of employee. Okay, like that. This is the one scenario. So we have four types of tolerances: vendor tolerance for vendor payment, and customer tolerance for customer payments, GL tolerance for GL payments and receipt, and employee tolerance, like that. Okay, and yeah. And yeah, next, my next question is, define tolerance group for GL. Define tolerance group for GL. And the next one, define tolerance group for employees. And this GL configuration we see, and GL and employees, later at the time of accounts payable, vendor will come. At the time of accounts receivable, customer will come. Okay. Okay, now my concern is very simple. How to define tolerance group for GL accounts? How to define tolerance group for GL accounts? And what is the T code for tolerance group for GL account? OBA0. OBA0. What is the T code on that? OBA0. So what is the path? This path is very important. Okay, and series one, SPRO financial, everyone please follow. SPRO financial accounting, new general ledger accounting, business transaction, open item clearing, clearing differences at the time of payment, at the time of reference, like a receipt, you need to clear the differences. And this is the one, define tolerance group for GLs. Okay, and my question is, how to define tolerance group for GL? Either you can go through T code or either you can go this path. So I'm going through path for your understanding purpose. Enter your SPRO, enter SAP reference IMG, and select here financial accounting, new, like general ledger accounting, new financial accounting, new general ledger accounting, new business area, and open item clearings, clearing differences, this one, define tolerance group for GL accounts. So go to additional information, display keys, IMG activities. What is the T code? OBA0. You just catch the point. Double click on here, define tolerance group for GL accounts. Double click on here and click on here, new entry. Enter here your company code, example GM10. Don't enter any information in the group field and write the description GM tolerance here. GM tolerance for GL account. See this one. Here you need to set percentage limit. What is my limit? 10 rupees. What is my limit? 10 rupees. So the system will allow any differences up to 10 rupees. System will allow. More than 10 rupees, system will not allow. If you allow, but system will not allow. System is like a robot. Okay, and when I enter 100 rupees, what happened? When I enter 100 rupees, what happened? System will allow any differences up to 100 rupees. System will allow. More than 100 rupees, system will not allow. So like this, you need to set one limit. Okay, Like example, I am setting 10 rupees or 1% of total invoice value, and 10 rupees total percent of total value of 1% of total invoice value. Okay, any limit, you may be 100 rupees, 5 rupees, 1 rupee, any limit you need to set here. Then company code, then the name, don't enter this field in this group, okay, and any value, limit and percentage, and click on your save. Then click on your next. One more company code, GM20. This is GM tolerance group for GL account. This is different company code, and 10 rupees 1% of invoice value, 10 rupees 1% of invoice value. Click on your save and back, and click on your go back. Do one thing, this is for GM10, this is for GM20. Description like that. Go back. So what is the tolerance? Very simple. If you want to see, double click on this, click on your position, enter your company code GM10, click on your OK. See here, this is the tolerance groups. And if you want to see, select here, click on your display. This is what I explained. Go back. The next one. What is the next one? The next one is define tolerance group for employees. Define tolerance group for employees. Okay. And the same path, like financial accounting new, general ledger accounting new, business transaction, and open item clearing, and clearing differences, and this one, define tolerance group for employees. What is the T code? OBA4. You just double click on this and click on your new entry. Click on your new entry and example, and don't enter any information in the group field. Directly you can enter company code GM10 here. What is the max example? 10 rupees 1%, and 10 rupees 1%. And what is the document value allowed? Enter here any big amount. Example, total document value, any value you can enter here. Example, I am entering here some value. Press enter. Okay, for example, why I am entering this value means when you deal with 10,000 rupees, you can contact salesman. When you deal with 10 lakhs rupees, when you deal with any 10 lakhs rupees, you need to contact your manager. When you deal with 1 crores rupees value, what can you do? Directly you can speak with the CEO. So based on the value, the designation, contact person designation will be changed. So that is the reason you can enter any value. Okay. And in case if you want to give any cash discounts, you can enter some example 10%, 2%, any cash discount if you required. Okay. When you contact salesman, he give 2% of cash discount. When you contact your manager, he give 5% of cash discount. When you contact CEO, he gives 20% of cash discount. Like that, based on the designations, discounts will be changed. Okay. Like if you want to enter any cash discount, you can enter, otherwise you can keep it empty. And this is the tolerances. limit 10 rupees or 1% of total invoice value. 10 rupees and 1% of total invoice value. This, who will give these percentages and this limit? You need to contact your client. For example, I am implementing GM group of company. So I need to contact GM group of company. They will give one limit. So based on their limit, you need to enter. Maybe 100 rupees, maybe 10 rupees, maybe 5 rupees, like that. Okay? Then click on your save and back. Then click on your next. Then GM20. Then press enter. So in the groups column, don't enter anything here. Why? Because this is the client level and I am creating company code level. Okay. Then go back. The next one is assign user to tolerance group. Assign user means at the time of SAP opening, I am enter username and password and client. So you need to assign client to tolerance group. So I didn't maintain any tolerance group. Anyway, you just understand here. Assign user to tolerance group. You just double click on here. And what is your user? See, SAP user. SAP user. And this is tolerance group. So don't maintain any specific tolerance group. Okay, you just keep it as a empty. Okay, why? Because we have different company codes and different tolerance groups available in the system. So when you assign specific group, all the company codes applicable only that group. Okay, that is the reason. Don't assign any specific group for the user, SAP user, you just keep it empty. Okay, then click on your save and back. Why I am not assigning any information here? When you assign specific tolerance group here, that is applicable for all the company codes and all the employee group and GL group and vendor group and all. Okay, so when I not assigned anything, that is depending on like your company code level. Why? Because I have different company codes and different tolerance groups and different objectives like that. So that is the reason I am not assigning anything here. Okay, and the real time the username is your name. Okay, then click on your save and back. Anyone any doubts regarding to tolerance? This is defined tolerance group for employees. This is defined tolerance group GLs. And this is tolerance group for assign user to tolerance groups. Anyone? Any doubts?
No doubt.
Yeah, no doubt, right? Very good.
That's correct. Yes.
And exchange rate, yeah. Yes, everyone. See this one. What is this? Can anyone read once this line?
Check exchange rate types.
Check exchange rate type. So what is meant by exchange rate?
There is a difference between currency level.
Yeah, there is differences for two currencies. For example,
yes.
Do one thing. Very good. For example, I will tell you one thing. I will tell you. Do one thing. For example, I have INR and USD. INR and USD. INR and Euro. E-U-R. John? In the France, you people used for euro, right? Euro currency.
Yes. 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 Yes.
Okay. Okay.
Euro.
Okay. All Europe countries used for euro only, right? Like France, German.
Yes.
All the countries.
Yeah. Yeah. Italy, Spain, Portugal.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
So in even in Russia, which currency?
Sorry?
In Russia, which currency they can use?
I forget. They don't use the euro.
So
ruble.
Okay, Russia.
Ruble.
Russia used for ruble, right? Okay.
Yeah. Ruble. Oh. Yeah.
Okay. Great. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Welcome.
Yeah. Example. Let it be. See here. What is meant by exchange rate means? Example. I have. INR to USD, INR to Euro, and INR to SGD. What is meant by SGD? Singapore dollar. SGD.
Singapore dollar.
INR to GBT.
Yeah, in Japanese. Trade
Britain pound. What is the current GBT, right?
Beautiful.
GPT or GPR?
GBP.
GBP.
Great Britain pound.
Great Britain pound. Like this, let's take one example. Let it be exchange rate means we are monitoring. You just example, let's take INR, Indian rupees, and compare to other currencies. Example, 1 USD dollar, how many rupees? Example, 1 USD dollar equal to, example, let it be 70 rupees. And 1 euro, example, equal to 65 rupees. This is exchange rates. 1 USD equal to how many rupees? 1 euro equal to how many rupees? Example, I'm telling you. Okay. One SGD equal to how many rupees? 45 rupees. And 1 GBP equal to how many rupees? Example, 90 rupees. Okay. So this is called exchange rates. This is called exchange rate. Do one thing. Concentrate here. Why this exchange rate is required means, when you post any accounting entry, so see this one. In the non-SAP, we are called accounting entry posting. In the SAP, we are called document entry posting. In the SAP, don't called accounting entry posting. You can called as a document entry posting. Document entry posting means accounting entry posting. Okay, you just catch the point. When you post any accounting entry posting, 3 currencies will be reflected. How many currencies will be reflected? 3 currencies. What is that? One is local currency. When you post any accounting entry, for your understanding, when you post any accounting entry in the SAP, how many currencies should be reflected? One is local currency, one is group currency, and one is transactional currency. So where you maintain this local currency? You are maintain local currency at the time of company code creation. Where you are maintain local currency, you know, even I gave one note at the time of company code creation. At the time of company code creation, whatever currency you are specified, that currency is called local currency. And what is meant by transactional currency? What is meant by transactional currency? At the time of accounting entry posting or at the time of document entry posting, whatever currency you are maintained, that currency is called transactional currency. That currency is called transactional currency. And what is meant by group currency? Do one thing. For example, let's take one example. Before going to example, you just understand here where I maintain this group currency. Go to SAP. Go to SAP slash and go back. Go to SCC4. What is the T code for maintain the group currency? SCC4. You note it down, this T code. SCC4. Press enter. So what is your client? 800 client. Okay, this is your client. Whatever currency you maintained in this field, example USD. USD is my group currency. And click on your change. See this one. This is my client. Whatever currency you are maintained into this field, that currency is called group currency. Okay, where? In the SCC4. Example, do one thing, you can understand one scenario. And do one thing. I have GM group of company, right? GM group of company. Where it is located? It is located in Europe. Example, let it be France. And under this group, I have two company codes. Just imagine, this is head office. All the CEOs, all the higher authority sitting in group of company. Okay, under this group of company, I have two company codes. What is that? And GM10 and GM20. This GM10 in India. GM20 in Singapore. Okay, and let be Singapore. This is an India, this is an Singapore, this is an France. So here in the GM10, what is the local currency? INR is the local currency. And what is the group currency? Euro, EUR. In the France is the Euro. This is at group of company at France. It is located in the France. My head office, head of the department sitting in the France. There they are maintaining Europe. So my group currency is Euro. My local currency is INR for GM10. My here GM20 local currency is SGD, Singapore. Got it my point, everyone?
Yes.
How the group currency, how the local currency will segregate? This GM20, this is GM Steels Private Limited in India. This is GM Steels Private Limited. This is GM Cement Limited in Singapore. Example I am saying, okay. And GM20 company code, local currency is SGD, group currency is Euro. And GM10 local currency is INR, group currency is Euro. And what is meant by transactional currency? Whatever currency you are maintained at the time of document entry posting, that currency is called transactional currency. Once again, I am telling you, when you post any document entry posting, there is three currencies should be reflected. One is local currency means your country currency, group currency means group of company currency, transactional currency, local currency, group currency and transactional currency. So this currency settings is very, very, very important. Okay, anyone, any doubts?
No doubt,
right? So means I will tell you one thing. Local currency means at the time of company code creation, where you maintain local currency at the time of company code creation. Where you maintain the group currency, you maintain group currency T code CC4. Just imagine, example, this group of company in US. Which, what is my group currency? USD, right? My group currency is USD. Why? Because this group of company in US. Just imagine. So, and go to SCC4, here USD. If your company in France, maintain Euro, EUR. Okay, and your group of company in another country, you maintain that currency here. Okay, example USD. Then click on your save and back. Got it, my point? And
yes.
Where you maintain group currency, T code SCC4. And where you maintain transactional currency, at the time of document entry posting. Just imagine, I want to post vendor invoice posting. I will tell you one thing. Go to FB70. Example, I am telling you how to post vendor invoice. I will tell you later. Now you can understand transactional currency. Example, what is this? This is called customer invoice. I am doing the sales to China. For example, I have one customer, he is staying in China. So which currency I maintained in the sale invoice? Naveen, use this question to you. I am sales to my China. Customer staying in China. So which currency I maintained to sales invoice? What is the China currency?
China currency is yuan.
China currency is yuan. So here, where is that? Here, this field you are maintain yuan. Okay, example yuan. So means, for example, do one thing that is called transactional currency. Okay, do one thing. I am sales to Indian customer only. So which currency I maintained here? INR. So my local currency is INR. My transactional currency also INR. Why? Because my customer staying in India only. Okay. For example, my customer staying in Paris. John is my customer. I am selling some material to John. So which currency I need to enter here? Euro. So what happened here? See here, my transaction currency is Euro, my local currency is INR, my group currency is USD. So, got it my point? My transactional currency is Euro, my local currency is INR, my group currency is USD.
Yes.
Like this, when you post any accounting entry, three currencies should be reflected. Okay, this is currency topic is very big topic. Even so, tomorrow is Saturday, right?
Yes.
So Saturday, Sunday.
Yes.
Take holiday. Take holiday. Let's meet on Monday. Okay.
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 Okay. Okay, everyone. Okay.